which she sat in, like a burnished throne burned on the water. The deck was beaten gold, purple the sails, and so perfumed that the winds were lovesick with them. The oars were silver, which to the tune of flutes kept stroke and made the water which they beat to follow faster as amorous of their strokes. For her own person, it beggared all description. She did lie in her pavilion, cloth of gold of tissue, or picturing that Venus where we see the fancy outwork nature, on each side her stood pretty dimpled boys, like smiling cupids, with divers-colored fans, whose wind did seem to glow the delicate cheeks which they did cool, and what they undid did. Her gentlewoman, like the Nereides, so many mermaids tended her i' the eyes, and made their bends adornings. At the helm a seeming mermaid steers, the silken tackle swell with the touches of those flower-soft hands that yearly frame the office. From the barge, a strange invisible perfume hits the sense of the adjacent wharfs. The city cast her people out upon her, and Antony, enthroned in the marketplace, did sit alone, whistling to the air, which but for vacancy had gone to gaze on Cleopatra too, and made a gap in nature. Age cannot wither her, nor custom stale her infinite variety. Other women cloy the appetites they feed, but she makes hungry where most she satisfies.